What's going on out there, everyone? It's Roll Easy here, and I'm back with another video here for GTA 5 Online, and it is a money glitch, all right? And basically, you guys remember the last video that I posted where, you know, it's a pretty inconvenient glitch. You needed two extra friends to actually do that glitch. No longer, all right? You only need one friend now to do that glitch. So it's no longer a three-person method. This is a two-person method now, all right? So as always, the founders will be linked down in the description. What you're going to need for this is obviously just one friend now. I'd say go ahead and go into a close friend session. It's much easier to join in and back out and stuff like that. So a close friend session. You need a facility, obviously, as the duper. You need an Avenger. You want to have an LG Retro Custom or some Benny's vehicle in your facility to be able to duplicate. No custom plates needed, so you get fresh generic plates every time, so you don't have to worry about dirty dupes. An MOC with the personal vehicle storage, and that's what we're going to be using to save the vehicles. And also, you want a garage somewhere full of Fagios or RHAs. You can even fill up the rest of your facility with Fagios or RHAs and use that. All right, and I also recommend setting your spawn location to the facility. Okay, so you guys are gonna see why we actually added that last step in there. But yeah, there's a couple new things that I did want to touch on. One of them about the MOC and saving the vehicles, and the other one is actually about the vehicle access and stuff like that. All right, like giving your friends access to your vehicles in the, you know, in the facility, because I know some people were having trouble with that. So stick to the end of the video and I will go over that very thoroughly. All right, so as the duper, I'm gonna go into my facility. My friend is also in there, and I'm just gonna hop into my Avenger. All right, so there's my friend over there. Now all I'm gonna do is hit right D-pad, and we're gonna be able to modify the vehicle. Hit B or circle right now and hover over exit the facility. Now you want to go ahead and smash exit the facility and then pause right after, all right? So you see that right there? Exit facility, pause. Just bring it up right after. If you do it, you know, boom, boom, you'll be good. So have your friend go ahead and hop into the passenger seat, all right? Once your friend sits down, he's on a black screen right now. Just like that, he gets an automatic black screen. So once that's happened, this is where we needed the third friend before. Not anymore. All we have to do now from the pause menu is go to creator. Make sure as the duper, you do not leave that pause menu. Just go straight to creator once your friend's on the black screen. Now, you can go back to your pause menu and you can actually go to the friends tab and join them through there. For some reason, I couldn't find them there, so I actually had to go over to my, you know, actually Xbox dashboard. But it's all good. Remember, I said we'll be in a closed friend session, so it's much easier to just join your friend back. No need for invites, so I don't recommend an invite only. All right, it'll make it much easier if we just join him back, you know, as in a closed friend session. You know, no need for invites whatsoever. So remember, I set my spawn location to the facility. This was the reason for that. So now that I've done that, I should spawn down over at the bed. You know, there we go, right at the facility. Now, he's actually, believe it or not, still on that black screen right now. Literally still on that black screen. Look, when I walk over, you see that he's still in the Avenger. Okay, he's glitched out. The facility is glitched. So what we're going to do is go ahead and go to pause online, and we're going to go to the Rockstar Created Missions and start up a Titan of a Job. Now, once we start up a Titan of a Job, we're going to be loading into the lobby, you know, the settings screen where we have all of our options to change. Now, once we're here, you can go ahead and like send your friend an invite to the job. On Xbox, we get automatic alerts sometimes. So if you get an automatic alert, that's, or if your friend gets an automatic alert, that's fine too. But your friend needs that first alert that says, are you sure you want to join your friend's job? Or, you know, are you sure you want to join the session? Once your friend is on that alert, you are free to go ahead and back out. Remember, don't tell him to accept it. Just tell him to tell you that he's on the alert, okay? So my friend's on the alert. I can go ahead and back out of the job. I'm going to tell him, go ahead and accept those alerts. So he's going to accept the first one, and then he's going to get an unable to connect. That's where he just went invisible. After the unable to connect, accept that one, he's going to spawn right back down in the Avenger in my facility, and that's it. He's glitched out. So no longer a three-person method, guys. Two players, nice and easy to glitch out the facility, and you only have to do this once. He can stay in the facility now while I just keep duping and duping and duping, okay? So super easy to get glitched out now, only a two-player method. Now remember, we need like a dummy vehicle outside to actually dupe over, okay? So like I was saying, you can have Fagios or RH8s in another garage, or you can have them in this garage. So check it out. I'm just going to grab this one. See, plate is VTE in the middle. So I'm just going to grab this RH8 and drive it outside. And, you know, this is all you need to do, all right, to dupe over a vehicle. All you need to do is have it outside. The last vehicle that you had outside is the one that gets duped over, and the plates from this vehicle go onto our brand new dupe, Okay, just like that. You guys know the deal with this, you know, with this facility, drive-in facility, teleport, you know, glitch. We've been doing it for a while now, all right? And remember, when you go back in the facility, you'll see yourself with your friend going down on the elevator, all right? That's how you know for sure that he's actually glitched out in there. All right, so now you want to make your way up the ramp, and we're going to be going to the LG Retro Custom, you know, or whatever Benny's vehicle you're using to dupe. I'm going to give him access to it, okay? And remember, I'm going to hop in, I'm going to go ahead and get the car started, tell him to go ahead and press Y, so he's going to tap it once, and then tap it again and hold, okay? And I'm going to get out before his butt touches that seat, and he should slide right over. So once again, what you want your friend to do is actually press Y or triangle once, so press let go, and then press and hold, okay? So he's actually pressing it twice, but the second time, he's holding it. All right, so press, let go, press, hold. That's what your friend's doing to get in there. And if that was too quick for you guys, I'm gonna stay tuned for the end of the video. I'm actually gonna go over fails and stuff to show you guys how to get better at it and what to look at, okay? So stick to the end of the video. Now, once your friend drives you over to this area, he wants to back in between these railings, and remember, you just want to be able to teleport in and out of the vehicle. Okay, so see that plate, KJP? That plate will be changing to the plate that we had outside. I think it was VTE. So we're going to go ahead and go over to the yellow circle, hit X and triangle at the same time, and that would be A and Y on PlayStation. If done correctly, sometimes you will see a flicker of you actually going into the retro. If not, usually it still works. It's pretty consistent, actually. But yeah, check it out. So VTE, here's our brand new duplicate, fresh plate. You will not get dupe detected selling this car, but remember, we can't sell it yet. We need to go ahead and drive it over to our MOC, all right? And so go ahead and request your MOC. Remember, it has to have the personal vehicle storage, so press right D-pad, and then you'll be able to drive in. Doesn't matter what's in the MOC, this will just transfer over to wherever you just got, you know, the RH8 from. Because remember, the game still technically thought that was an RH8. So wherever the RH8 came from, that is now where your vehicle inside the MOC went to, okay? So once we've done that, I actually went ahead and I drove back, and I didn't realize this till the next time, guys, but the MOC does not despawn, okay? While your friend's glitched out in the facility, the MOC won't despawn, and you'll see what I mean later. But yeah, so call out, you know, I use my motorcycle club menu and I just called out a Blazer. Coincidentally, it was the Blazer that was in the facility also. But yeah, this will be the next vehicle that we're going to be duping over. So I'm just going to dupe one more car for you here real quick. I don't know if you can see those plates there. I think it's 545 at the very end. But yeah, we're just going to go ahead and make our way into the facility. Now, once we go in there, we're going to be doing the same thing. And remember, you're always looking for this animation, the animation of you going down the elevator with your friend, even though we just went into the facility by ourselves. Okay, that is your indication that he is still glitched out and you can still continue the glitch. So we have our dummy vehicle outside that we're going to be duping, and I'm going to show you how to gain the vehicle access again here. So I'm going to hop in and I'm going to wait to get the car started. I'm going to let him know that I'm ready to go. All right, so right after he opens up the door, before his butt touches the seat, I'm gonna go ahead and get out. And remember, he's tapping wire triangle once, and then he's tapping it again and holding it, all right? So press let go, press hold, all right? That's the friend, that is how the friend is getting the vehicle access, okay? Just like that. So once again, we're gonna go ahead and park, well, he's gonna park my vehicle over here by the railings so that it'll be really easy for me to teleport. No need to use other cars to wedge the other doors or anything like that. So I should be able to teleport fine right from this position. Let's see, yep, pressing wire triangle, I can teleport easily. All right, so that plate will be changing. You're gonna see right here, remember the drill, guys, go to the yellow circle, kind of face towards the car, A and Y at the same time, all right? X and triangle on PlayStation. You don't always see that flicker of you going into the retro, but usually it still works, all right? Just take my word for it. So check it out. There we go. There's the new plate, 545 at the end. But check this out. This is what I really wanted to show you. So you see, I still have a minute, 20 seconds to request the MOC. And I was like, damn, okay, well, that's weird. And I was thinking about waiting here. And I was like, you know what? Let me just drive over to the spot. And look at the timer. The timer's still going off. But look as I get closer. Boom, your mobile operation center is already nearby. And I look on the map and I was like, yo, it is still out there. I didn't have to recall it. I never had to doing this glitch. While your friend is glitched out in the facility, your MOC actually stays outside. At least it did for me when I was making this video. So I would definitely recommend checking that. So the first time you request your MOC after your friend's glitched out in there and you're saving the car, I recommend actually driving that over to the facility and actually just parking it right outside the facility, okay? So here's the timing, as I promised real quick, to show you about giving friends vehicle access. So this is too late of a timing, all right? So you see, he's gonna try to get in, And look at that. He's already sat down, and then I go ahead and get out. See, he doesn't slide over to the driver's seat. That is too late, okay? As you can see by the bottom left. So now I'm going to show you too early, all right? Two of them are too early, all right? So check it out. So he's going to go ahead, and obviously, he didn't even open the door yet, and I was out. So he just opened the door, and then that was it. This one, he actually was able to open the door, but look at that. He gets kicked right out, and that's because that was also too early. This is the perfect timing, all right? After the door opens, before his butt touches the seat. See? Right there. I almost missed it, but I was able to get it, okay? And I'm telling you, it does work a lot better if your friend taps wire triangle once, press and let go, and then press and hold, okay? So those are basically the new tips that I want to give for this glitch. This glitch is a lot more consistent now and a lot easier to do and more convenient to do as well, okay? Only one friend, nice and simple, all right? So that's going to be it for me, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. My name is Roll Easy. Check out the MOC. It's still out there. If you're brand new to the channel, make sure to hit that big red subscribe button, turn on post notifications, and drop a fat like on this video and the rest of my videos for the freshest and the most informative dope GTA 5 online content. Road to 25K. Peace out, guys.